Now, Trey Gowdy, a Republican out of South Carolina, member of the House Oversight and Government Reform Committee and the House Judiciary Committee. Sir, good morning to you. I know you'll be asking questions at this hearing tomorrow. What do you want to know, sir?
Good morning, Bill. The first thing I would ask, I want you to imagine the scenario. You're at home and you call 911. Not only do the police not respond, they actually withdraw the patrol cars that are in your neighborhood. There were repeated requests for more security in Libya. Not only did they not get more security, they didn't even get the status quo. They got a decrease. So, my colleague Jason Chaffetz just returned from Libya. I suspect that he's going to take the lead on this line of questioning. I continue to want to know post 9/11, post event, why Susan Rice was the last person in America to know that this was not a spontaneous incident. This was pre-planned, premeditated. She went on 5 different talk shows and stated, in fact, that it was spontaneous when, in fact, it was not. So I'm going to focus my line of questioning on that. Jason Chaffetz and others will focus on the fact that these requests were denied.
Yeah. This is Lieutenant Colonel Andrew Wood. He's done 2 interviews that I know of now, ABC and CBS. This is how he described the request for security on CBS with Cheryl Atkinson.
He was constantly concerned about the threats to not just himself, but the entire staff there.
Was there what you saw as a visible security drawdown during the period of time you were in Libya?
Yes. It began just shortly after I arrived. There was pressure to reduce the number of security people there.
Pressure from where?
Higher headquarters at State Department.
All right, that from CBS News, and perhaps we hear more of that tomorrow. Now, this is what the State Department's going to say. It's going to say that even after that team left in August, there was an equal number of people who replaced them with the same skill sets. And it'll also say that the security support team would have been in Tripoli and not in Benghazi, some 1,000 miles away. Now, does that matter to you? How do you factor that into this equation trying to understand this?
Well, there's nothing quite like putting people under oath to get better responses. So we'll see who shows up from the State Department. This much I know. The British ambassador was targeted twice. Our consulate in Benghazi was attacked twice. We requested more guns, more support. We didn't even get the status quo. We got less. The other question to ask, Bill, is why was the State Department so intent on creating the appearance that everything was going swimmingly in Libya, that things had been normalized, when in reality that was not the case? So, I I'm going to focus on why the State Department ignored the obvious in Libya, why they misled the American people shortly after the attack. The gentleman that you just played the video from, I believe, is going to testify tomorrow.
That's right.
And I look forward to asking him some questions.
Here's another thing that we're trying to piece together here. You mentioned Susan Rice, who went on 5 different network talk shows on a Sunday, 5 days after the assault was reported. But apparently, according to James Rosen out of our Washington bureau, on the night of September 12th now, so this is 24 hours after Stevens and 3 others are dead, he had a briefing with members on Capitol Hill and talked about the strong appearance that this was the result of a terrorist attack. So that was about 5 days before the interviews with Susan Rice. How do you then piece that together and trying to understand who was talking to whom at the administration?
Well, I think you're referring to the Undersecretary of State, Patrick Kennedy, who shortly after this attack, within hours, said that it was pre-planned and premeditated. And then the ambassador to the United Nations goes on, as you say, 5 talk shows to say that this was a spontaneous reaction to a video. Jason Chaffetz just got back from Libya. Not one single solitary person mentioned this video to him. Not one in the entire time that he was there. There was a rock that sat on the desk of a judge I used to work for that said the government speaks with one voice. This administration would do well to put that same rock on their desk. You can't have multiple explanations and just hope that one happens to be the truth and that we ignore the others. Susan Rice was either misinformed, which I'm inclined to give her the benefit of the doubt, or she intentionally misled you, me, and others. And we're going to find out what happened starting tomorrow.
Trey Gowdy, thank you. We'll be watching the hearing from here. Trey Gowdy in South Carolina today. Thank you for your time, sir.
Thank you, sir.